Good morning.
It's my pleasure to be with you today.
大家早上好，今天很高兴能跟大家在一起。
I give you greetings from 10th Presbyterian Church in Philadelphia.
我从我们费城的教会来给你们的基督教会来给你们祝福和问候。
It was a joy to serve in ministry with your pastor.
很高兴能跟你们的牧师一起来侍奉我们的上帝。
And to get to know his wife Rong Chen, and who became a friend of my wife Anne.
来也很高兴认识他的太太陈，然后跟我的太太安成为一个好朋友。
Today I'd like to speak with you on the meaning of Jesus' birth.
今天我想跟大家分享一下耶稣基督诞生的意义。
From Matthew 1:18-25.
从马太福音第一章第十八节到第二十五节。
Do you want to just read it?
那我就来念一下。马太福音第一章第十八节，耶稣基督降生的日事记在下面。他母亲玛利亚已经许配了约瑟，还没有迎娶，玛利亚就从圣灵怀了孕。她丈夫约瑟是个义人，不愿意明明的羞辱她，想要暗暗的把她休了。正思念这事的时候，主的使者向他梦中显现说，大卫的子孙约瑟，不要怕，只管娶过你的妻子玛利亚来，因她所怀的孕是从圣灵来的。她将要生一个儿子，你要给他起名叫耶稣，因他要将自己的百姓从罪恶里救出来。这一切的事成就是要应验主借先知所说的话，说必有童女怀孕生子，人要称他的名为以马内利。以马内利翻出来就是神与我们同在。约瑟醒了起来，就遵着主使者的吩咐把妻子娶过来，只是没有和他同房，等他生了儿子就给他起名叫耶稣。
Have you ever wondered why Christmas is celebrated?
大家有没有想过我们为什么要庆祝圣诞节呢？
With all the decorations and Santa Claus and parties and shopping and gift giving,
在这一切交换礼物、圣诞老公公、我们各种的装饰、各种的聚会，在这其中，
you may never really come to a true understanding of what is the significance of Jesus' birth.
我们可能没有真正的想到耶稣基督诞生的重要的意义。
What is so special about Jesus' birthday?
我们庆祝耶稣基督的生日有什么特殊的意义呢？
Why do almost 2 billion people in the world celebrate it every year?
为什么地球上的二十亿人每年都来庆祝这个节日？
Was Jesus different from other great men, religious leaders, or prophets?
耶稣基督跟其他的宗教领袖、其他的先知有什么区别呢？
Let's look at our text to see if it tells us something about the uniqueness of Jesus.
让我们从今天的经文来学习耶稣基督和这些人不同的地方。
I'd like to make 4 points which give us the essence of what our text is saying.
我想把今天我们这个信息分成四点。
First, Jesus was conceived by God the Holy Spirit.
耶稣基督是从圣灵感孕而生。
Second, Jesus' birth was to save us from our sins.
耶稣基督的诞生是把我们从我们的罪中救赎出来。
Third, Jesus' birth was the fulfillment of prophecy, thus the center of God's plan for us.
耶稣基督的诞生是应验了先知所说的上帝的计划。
And fourth, through Jesus' birth, God is with us.
第四点，因着耶稣基督的诞生，我们能与上帝同在。
Mary was pledged to or engaged to be married to Joseph.
耶稣的母亲玛利亚要跟约瑟订婚。
In Jewish society, engagement was taken much more seriously than it is in our own.
在犹太的传统中，这种订婚比我们现在的所谓订婚要严肃很多。
It was considered to be married in a legal sense.
就像是在法律上，这两个人已经结婚了。
Only the marriage was not yet consummated.
只不过是这个婚礼还没有举行。
One who was pledged to be married had to be divorced to break up that pledge.
当他们如果是订婚以后，如果是 违反那个婚约的时候，就相当于是离婚。
And if one of the two should die, the other would be considered a widow or a widower.
如果他们其中一个人死了，在结婚之前死了，订婚以后死了的时候，另外一个女方被就会被看成是，或者男方被看成是官夫或者是寡妇。
Mary and Joseph had not yet been together yet.
玛利亚和约瑟还并没有在一起。
However, Mary was found to be pregnant.
虽然他们没有同房，但是玛利亚发现她怀孕了。
Now this would be shocking and shameful thing in Jewish society.
在犹太的传统中，这是一个很让人羞耻的事情。
So Joseph decided he would just quietly divorce her and not make a big scene about it, not to shame her.
约瑟只不过是想偷偷的、暗暗的把玛利亚给休了，不要让玛利亚受太大的羞辱。
So he didn't want to bring public ridicule, and he wanted to maintain his own righteousness.
他不愿意再通过这些公众的这些法律程序来维护他自己的权利。
He could not, in good conscience, marry Mary, who is now thought to have been unfaithful.
对于他自己的就是自己的良心来说，他自己也不愿意接受玛利亚这个被认为是一个犯了奸淫罪的这个女人。
But Joseph must have brought this matter to the Lord in prayer.
约瑟一定在他的祷告中把这个事情向神说了。
Looking to his direction on what to do.
他在祷告中寻求他该怎么做。
And before acting too quickly and rashly, Joseph waited patiently for a word from God.
在他莽撞地做这种决定之前呢，他耐心地等待上帝给他的指示。
And as we wait on God in prayer,He will not fail to answer us too.
当我们在耐心的等待，在祷告中等待上帝的应许和回答的时候，上帝也同样会给我们回答。
Joseph must have had in mind God's promise in Proverbs.
约瑟脑子里一定想着神在这个箴言中所给他们的应许。
Trust in the Lord with all your heart.
用你的心来信靠耶和华。
And lean not on your own understanding.
不要依靠你自己的聪明。
In all your ways, acknowledge him.
在所有的事情上都要信靠他。
And he will make your path straight.
他一定会指引你的路。
No sooner had Joseph thought from his own understanding that he must quietly divorce Mary.
虽然约瑟自己心里想他可能会暗暗的会休掉玛利亚。
Then an angel appeared to Joseph in a dream.
但是一个位天使在约瑟的梦中向他显现
，and said, "Joseph, son of David,"
他说约瑟上大卫的子孙
，"Do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife."
不要怕，只管娶过你的妻子玛利亚来
，"Because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit."
因为她所怀的孕是从圣灵所怀的孕。
It was an angel of God who spoke to Joseph.
在这里，主的使者向他显现。
Now it had been 400 years since God had given the Jewish people any special revelation through his prophets.
上一次主的使者向以色列人显现已经在400年前的事情了。
Now angels had appeared at times to them bearing a message from God.
在那个400年前使者向以色列人显现是宣告上帝的话语。
Throughout Israel's history,
在以色列的历史当中
Now an angel brought a revelation from God to Joseph.
400年以后，天使又给约瑟显现，然后告诉约瑟上帝的旨意。
Revealing the meaning of what had happened to Mary.
告诉他在玛利亚身上发生了什么。
Only as a revelation from God does any of the events in the Bible and in Jesus' life have any significance for us.
在耶稣基督的生命当中，神的显现告诉我们他整个生命的重要性。
Now, twice we see in our text says that Jesus was conceived by the Holy Spirit.
在这一节里面，我们两次看到使者向我们以色列人说，耶稣基督是从圣灵所孕。
Luke gives us an account of the angel Gabriel appearing to Mary.To announce the birth of Jesus.
在路加福音，天使加百列向玛利亚显现，告诉他，向他宣告耶稣基督的诞生。
He responded to Mary's question of how this could be since she was a virgin.
天使长加百列对玛利亚这个问题，我还没有结婚，为什么可以生孩子这件事的回应是
？He said, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you."
圣灵已经降在你的身上。
And the power of the Most High will overshadow you.
我们全能的上帝光照你。
So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God.
所以要生的这位圣者要称为神的儿子。
Of course, this was a great miracle.
当然这是一个伟大的奇迹。
It cannot be explained scientifically.
我们从科学上没有办法来解释。
Our feeble reasoning and understanding cannot be compared to what appears to be the impossible that God can do.
那我们这些凡人所想的这些方法也没有办法来解释上帝的这个神迹。
God is not limited by the laws of science.
上帝是不会因为科学的一些规条被科学的规条所限制。
Because he made those laws.
因为上帝创造了这些规律。
He is our creator.
他是我们的创造者。
If we believe God could create the universe,
如果我们相信我们的上帝能够创造宇宙，
we can believe that Jesus was conceived with no human father.
所以我们也可以相信耶稣基督可以不用人类的父亲就可以在玛利亚肚中受孕。
God governs the whole universe, and He can do anything.
上帝主宰整个宇宙，他可以做任何的事情。
Now, those who denied Jesus' virgin birth,
那些否认耶稣基督是从圣女童女玛利亚所生
usually will also deny that Jesus is divine, that is God.
也同样是否定耶稣基督是上帝的儿子。
And they will also deny the authority of the scriptures.
他们也同样否定我们圣经的权威。
Now, if Jesus was not conceived by a virgin,
如果耶稣基督不是从童女而生，
then Jesus would not be whom the Bible teaches us he is.
这就跟我们圣经所说的不一样。
The divine, sinless Son of God.
而圣经告诉我们，耶稣基督是无罪的，上帝的羔羊，神的儿子。
Now, Jesus' mother was a person just like any of us.
耶稣基督母亲就像我们平常人一样。
But was blessed by God.
但是受上帝的祝福。
To have the privilege of giving birth to God's one and only Son.
他可以有这样的权柄，有这样的特权，能够生下来上帝的儿子。
She was not born sinless.
玛利亚本身是一个罪人
，as the Roman Catholic Church teaches，
就像是罗马天主教所说的
，for she calls God her Savior in Luke 1:47，
因为她叫上帝是我的救赎主，在路加福音里面说。
Joseph was Jesus' legal father，
而约瑟是耶稣基督法律上的父亲
，but Jesus was not physically a descendant of his。
耶稣基督却不是他肉身的后裔。
After Jesus' birth, Mary had normal sexual relations with her husband Joseph.
当耶稣基督出生以后，玛利亚也跟继续像我们常人一样跟丈夫同房。
For verse 25 says,
在第二十五节说
，But he had no union with her until she gave birth to a son.
只等玛利亚生了耶稣基督以后。约瑟才跟玛利亚同房。
They subsequently had several children.
他们随后也继续有了几个孩子。
Such as James.
像James.
Joseph.
和约瑟和雅各。
Judas.
犹大。
And Simon.
西门。
As well as sisters.
甚至有妹妹。
You see that in Mark 6:3.
我们可以在马可福音第三章看到。
Now, one article of faith that Muslims and Christians hold in common is the virgin birth of Jesus.
在伊斯兰教和犹太教有一个共同的、大家都承认的地方，就是玛利亚生耶稣基督的时候是一个童女。
Although they believe in the virgin birth, they deny Jesus' divinity.
然而在伊斯兰教里面他否认了耶稣基督的这个神性。
They explained that as God created Adam, so he created Jesus.
他们说就像是上帝创造亚当一样，上帝也创造了耶稣。
According to Muslim tradition, the Hadith,
根据穆斯林的这个传统 Hadith,
the angel Gabriel blew up Mary's dress and thus she was impregnated.
天使就吹开了玛利亚的裙子，然后玛利亚就怀孕了。
Thus, they deny that God, the Holy Spirit, brought about the conception directly.
他们就否认了圣灵感孕这件事情。
And they confuse the angel Gabriel with the Holy Spirit.
他们把天使加百列跟圣灵混为一谈。
Because they deny the Trinity.
因为他们否认三位一体。
So they just see Jesus as simply a man who was a prophet.
所以他们只把耶稣基督看成是一个先知一个人。
The miracle of Jesus' virgin birth shows us the two natures of Christ Jesus.
而耶稣基督从童女感孕被生下来这件事情呢，反映了耶稣基督两个性质。
He was both human and divine.
他是百分之百的人，他也是百分之百的神。
As a human, Jesus was able to identify with us in our predicament.
所以同样的，他如果是一个完全的人一样，他可以跟我们一样。
Jesus suffered the same kind of afflictions that we all suffer from.
他跟我们一样要经历我们一样的痛苦。
He was tempted to sin, but remained sinless.
他会被引诱，但是他不会犯罪。
He experienced hunger and thirst.
他同样会饿，会渴。
He suffered physical pain.
他同样会痛。
Sweat, blood, and tears.
他会流泪，他会流汗。
He comes alongside of us and lifts our burdens.
他站在我们边上，站在我们旁边来担当我们的罪，担起我们的担子。
And because of this, Jesus is as a brother and friend to us.
就因为他是百分之百的人，他就可以成为我们的朋友，成为我们的弟兄。
We can take comfort in our sufferings.
我们可以在我们的苦难当中寻求安慰。
In meditating on the sufferings of Jesus as a man like us.
当我们想到耶稣基督是百分之百的人的时候，他同样经历过我们的痛苦，超过我们的痛苦。
On the other hand, Jesus was God.
另一方面，耶稣也是百分之百的神。
Jesus' divine nature came by the fact that he was conceived by God the Holy Spirit.
耶稣基督的百分之百的神性是来源于他受圣灵感孕。
The Holy Spirit is the third person of the Trinity.
圣灵是上帝第三个位格。
That is, God is one God in three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
一个上帝有三个位格，圣父、圣子和圣灵。
It was necessary for God the Father to send His Son to earth.
上帝差派他的儿子来到这个世界是非常必要的。
To show us the Father that we might know Him.
向我们展示我们的天父是什么样的。
He also sent His Son to provide a holy sacrifice for our sins in the person of Jesus.
他同样 把他的儿子差派给我们，就是耶稣基督，因他的死担当我们的罪。
And through that to provide for our salvation.
把他作为挽回祭来挽救我们。
But salvation from what?
但是把我们从何什么地方给挽救回来呢？
Jesus' birth was to save us from our sins.
耶稣基督的诞生是为了来挽救我们的把我们从罪中挽回出来。
We see it even in Jesus' name.
我们从耶稣基督的名字就可以看出来。
The angel recognized the responsibility and authority Joseph had in naming Mary's son.
耶稣天使向约瑟启示，告诉他耶稣基督应该叫什么样的名字。
He told Joseph in a dream.
他在梦中对约瑟说
，Mary will give birth to a son.
玛利亚要生一个儿子。
And you are to give him the name Jesus.
你要给他起名叫耶稣。
Because he will save his people from their sins.
因他要将自己的百姓从罪恶中救出来。
We see here that even Jesus' name was a revelation from God.
我们这里看到耶稣基督这个名字也是上帝的启示。
We're given two names for our Lord in this passage.
在这一节中间，我们给了我们耶稣基督有两个名字。
Jesus is a name for his office, that is his role and position.
耶稣给他的名字是他的能力，给他，他是把我们从罪恶中救出来。
And Emmanuel is a name for his nature.
而以马内利是的名字是指出他的本性。
The name Jesus is the Greek form of the name Joshua in Hebrew.
耶稣的名字在希伯来中就是 Joshua， 约书亚。
It means the Lord saves，
就是上帝拯救。
Or Yahweh is salvation，
或者是上帝就是我们的拯救。
In explaining the meaning of Jesus' name, the angel seems to refer to Psalm 130, verse 8.
在这一节，天使给耶稣起名字的时候，是指出了在诗篇里面所说的。
Where it says, He or God Himself will redeem Israel from all their sins.
上帝要把以色列从他们的罪恶中救出来。
Note that it is God, not us, who saves.
大家记住，只有上帝，而不是我们来拯救。
But saves us from what?
同样把我们从何处来拯救出来？
Is it from sickness?
是从病痛当中吗？
Demons?
从魔鬼的手中吗？
Disaster，
或者从灾难当中？
Oppression，
或者是压力下面？
No， although deliverance from these things are sometimes a sign of God's saving power。
当我们在这些事情当中被拯救出来的时候，只不过是上帝给我们拯救的一部分。
What Jesus saves us from is sin。
耶稣基督把我们从我们的罪当中拯救出来。
Now all of us are sinners.
我们所有的人都是罪人。
We are separated from our holy God by our sin.
因着我们的罪，我们全至圣的上帝隔绝了。
He will not receive us into His eternal kingdom, of which He is King, with our sin.
因着我们的罪，他在他永恒的神的国度当中，他不会接纳我们。
We all deserve the judgment and the eternal punishment of God.
因着我们的罪，我们都会受到上帝永恒的审判。
Because we rebel against His authority over us.
因为我们反叛了上帝。
We disobey Him.
我们不遵从他给我们的命令。
And we don't glorify Him with our lives.
我们不用我们的生命来给他荣耀。
We don't want God to rule over us.
我们不想让上帝来统治我们。
We are selfish.
我们很自私。
Proud.
我们很骄傲。
Hateful.
我们有恨。
Unforgiving.
我们不愿意原谅别人。
Thankless.
我们不愿意感谢人。
And lack love for God and our neighbor.
我们既不爱上帝，也不爱我们的邻舍。
However, despite all that,
然而，虽然我们有这些
，God loves us so much that He sent Jesus to save us from His judgment and wrath or His anger.
上帝是这样的爱我们，所以他差派了他的独生子耶稣基督来，把我们从他的愤怒当中拯救出来。
It was only God Himself who could save us.
只有上帝自己来才能拯救我们。
We could do nothing to save ourselves.
我们自己什么也不能做。
All our good works and best efforts,
我们所有的好的工作，或者是我们的所有的成就
，could not wipe away and cleanse us from our sin,
也不能来洗净我们的罪
，nor from our sinful nature,
也不能使我们与我们的罪性隔绝
，that we are born with,
因为这罪性是从我们生下来就有了。
Only Jesus' death and resurrection from the dead,
只有耶稣基督的受死和复活
，was able to bring us to salvation.
才能带给我们拯救。
But when we put our faith and trust in the finished work of Jesus on our behalf,
当我们把我们的信心放到耶稣基督为我们成就的工作上以后
，that He accomplished for us on the cross,
他在十字架上为我们成就了救恩
，then God does not see our sin anymore.
上帝透过他就看不到我们的罪了。
The sacrificial blood of Jesus spilt on the cross.
耶稣基督在十字架上所洒的鲜血
washes all our sin away，
就把我们的罪都洗净了。
Jesus paid a price for our salvation by His self-sacrifice once for all。
耶稣基督因着他一次和永远的献祭，就把我们从罪恶当中拯救出来。
Now God accepts us。
现在，我们的上帝因着耶稣基督拯救接受了我们
as holy。
把我们看作是圣洁的。
That is as clean from sin and justified. That is free from guilt.
在 通过耶稣基督的宝血，我们被称义，我们不再被看作是罪人，我们与我们的罪隔绝。
Now we no longer need to suffer shame.
在耶稣基督里，我们不应该再有这种羞耻感。
We have been honored through Christ.
因着耶稣基督，我们被尊崇。
Accepted into the family of God.
接纳入神国的大家庭。
We are adopted sons and daughters of God.
我们已经被上帝来收养。
This doesn't mean we are saved from hardship.
并不是说我们在我们的生活当中就没有困难。
And conflict.
我们生活当中就没有这样的挣扎了。
And the cross that we too must bear.
我们在我们的生活当中同样要背起我们的十字架。
But we are saved from our sins forever.
但是我们在永恒当中，我们已经从我们耶稣基督已经把我们从我们的罪中救拔出来。
Jesus delights in showing us His mercy and grace.
耶稣基督这世界的光，让我们看到了他的慈爱，他的怜悯。
For that's why He came.
这就是为什么他来的原因。
As it says in John 3:17, for God did not send His Son into the world to condemn the world.
在约翰福音三章十七节说，上帝差派他的耶稣基督不是来审判世人的。
But to save the world through Him.
而是通过耶稣基督来拯救世人。
We are received by faith into God's kingdom.
我们通过我们的信心，我们被接纳入神的国度。
And through that faith accepted as sons and daughters of God.
通过我们的信心，我们被神接纳成他的儿女。
But all of this that I just explained to you about salvation from our sin.
这所以上的都是我向大家解释，把我们从我们的罪当中救赎出来这件事。
Was not just some kind of an afterthought on the part of God.
并不是就是说，当上帝做完这些事以后，我们所想。
It was a long time before the foundation of the world, the plan of God.
这个计划在上帝创造宇宙之前就已经有了。
Jesus' birth was the fulfillment of prophecy.
耶稣基督的诞生是应验先知所说的。
Our text says, all this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet.
22节说，这一切的事成就就是要应验主借先知所说的话。
In the days of Ahaz, king of Judah,
在犹大国的这个时候。
Isaiah gave him a sign from God.
以先知以赛亚因上帝的启示
that God would deliver him from his enemies to the north.
上帝说他要把他从北国的这个敌人当中给解救出来。
Israel and Syria.
以色列和叙利亚。
The prophecy was.
预言就是
In Isaiah 7:14,
在以赛亚书第七章第十四节
Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign.
所以上帝会给你一个神迹
The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel.
童女要生子，你要叫他给他起名叫以马内利。
The Hebrew word for virgin is Alma.
希伯来语的这个童女的意思叫 Alma,
which can also mean a young woman of marriageable age,
就是那些女孩子可以结婚到了结婚年龄的这些女孩子。
Now in its original context, it may have been referring to a normal birth of a son to a young woman.
在如果大家只看这字面的意思的话，可能只不过是一个平常的女子生一个儿子。
But Matthew takes this prophecy of a virgin as a type or a sign of the Virgin Mary.
所以在而马太在这里把这个童女指向的是这个童女玛利亚。
The name Emmanuel.
而以马内利这个名字。
God is with us.
神与我们同在。
Was to convince King Ahaz that God would deliver him from his enemies.
所以就是在这个阿哈斯这个王对阿哈斯说，神要给我们一个儿子，把我们从敌人的手中拯救出来。
Now in Matthew, it is applied to Jesus.
而在马太福音里面，把这个名字就给了耶稣基督。
As giving us final fulfillment to God being with us in the fullest sense.
就成全了上帝给我们这个应许，神与我们同在。
So in this fulfillment of prophecy, we see the significance of the birth of Jesus.
所以在这个应验当中，主应验先知所说的话当中，我们看到耶稣基督诞生的重要意义。
The Son of the Virgin Mary is the incarnate God.
而童女或怀孕生子的这个耶稣基督就是上帝道成肉身的。
Who is with us to save us from sin by putting our trust in Him.
通过我们对耶稣基督的信心和信靠，把我们从最终拯救出来。
Now 12 times in the Gospel of Matthew, the author says that the events taking place are fulfilling prophecy.
在马太福音中间有12次说到事情的成就是应验先知所说的话。
That is, the Old Testament is being fulfilled in the New Testament.
这是在旧约圣经的这些预言被应验到新约圣经当中。
Now here in verse 23, Matthew quotes for us from Isaiah the prophet when he wrote about 725 years before Jesus' birth about him.
在23节所说的这段预言就是先知以赛亚在725年以前所说的这个预言。
This is a powerful testimony to the divine origin of the Bible.
这是对这个圣经的这个权威性和神性的这个重要的支持。
That is, the Bible came from God, not from human imagination.
说这是因为圣经是从神而来，而不是因为我们人的这种想象所写的。
This fulfillment of prophecy shows the Bible's accuracy in small details.
而这个应验这一段的先知的话，是让我们看到圣经的完全的正确性。
In fact, this is the first of over 50 quotations, most of them concerning Jesus being the Messiah that Matthew makes from the Old Testament.
在旧约里面，有超过50多次的指到耶稣基督的诞生是救赎主这件事情，而这个所引用的是这50次当中的第一次。
Another way in which connection is made that Jesus is fulfilling prophecy is when the angel appeared to Joseph in a dream.
另外，我们看到另外一个应验，先知所说的话是看到这个使者天使向约瑟在梦中显现。
The angel calls.Joseph, son of David.
使得主的使者天使向约瑟显现的时候，叫他是大卫的子孙约瑟。
Now this is significant because the Messiah or Christ was prophesied to be a descendant of King David.
这非常的重要，因为在先知的所有预言当中说到，我们的耶稣基督应该是大卫的子孙。
And he was to rule on his throne forever.
是在他的宝座上掌权，直到永远。
Now David had been king of Israel 1,000 years before.
而大卫是在一千多年前是犹大国的王帝。
The preceding section of our text gives the genealogy of Jesus from Abraham to David and from David to Joseph.
在前面第一章给了耶稣基督的家谱，让我们看到大卫是亚伯拉罕的子孙，而耶稣是大卫的子孙。
Being called the son of David would have alerted Joseph to the role he was to play.
把约瑟叫成大卫的子孙是要提醒他要做什么样的事情。
In a legal sense, Joseph was the father of Jesus.
从法律上来说，约瑟是耶稣的父亲。
Mary also was a descendant of King David as given in the genealogy in the Gospel of Luke.
在路加福音里面，我们也可以看到玛利亚也是大卫的子孙。
Now, in pointing out this fulfillment of prophecy, Matthew is making a link between the Old Testament and the New Testament.
当我们看到这个，当马太写出这个耶稣基督的家谱的时候，我们看到马太把耶稣基督从旧约联系到新约。
Now, as I said, there had been 400 years since any prophet had come from God with revelation from him.
我刚才已经提到，在耶稣基督诞生之前400年，已经上帝已经不再向以色列人有启示。
But now God was speaking again.
在这个时候，上帝又说话了。
Only now God was speaking and acting on our behalf through the sending of His Son.
在这时候，这上帝所说的是指向他的子孙大卫的子孙所说的。
It was in God's plan to send His Son from us to save us from our sins from the very beginning.
他告诉我们，他要差派他的儿子在我们当中，把我们从我们的罪拯救出来。
Thus, Jesus' birth was in the center of God's plan for our redemption.
而耶稣基督是上帝拯救计划的核心。
And since the creation of the world,
从上帝创造天地以来,
Jesus has had the names of those he will save in the book of life.
在神的生命册上，耶稣基督已经写下了一些要拯救人的名字。
In other words, Jesus' incarnation, that is coming in the flesh,
换句话说，耶稣基督是上帝道成肉身。
Is a continuation of God's revelation, His speaking to us.
是上帝的启示的一大部分。
God is a personal God.
我们的上帝是有位格的上帝，是有个性的上帝。
Who communicates with us and relates to us.
他跟我们说话。
He does not just reveal His will and requirements to us.
他不仅仅只是告诉我们他给我们的要求或者他的旨意。
As we see in the Quran.
就像我们在《可兰经》里面看到这些，穆罕默德写出来给这些那些信徒。
But he desires a relationship with us.
而我们的上帝希望跟我们建立关系。
He makes a covenant, that is an agreement with us.
他跟我们立约。
In which he had certain requirements of us in our relationship.
他在这个约当中有希望我们做一些事情。
There are blessings if we keep the covenant.
如果我们守约的话，它会有祝福。
And curses if we break the covenant.
如果我们毁约的话，就会有咒诅。
But it is God who takes the initiative.
但是神总是首先做这样的事情。
It is He who calls us.
他首先来，呼召我们。
The story of the Bible is that of God calling His people into a relationship with Himself.
而圣经所记载的就是上帝呼召他的儿女跟他建立关系。
Because that relationship had been broken since the time of Adam and Eve's fall in the garden.
而与上帝的关系在亚当和夏娃在伊甸园里面犯罪以后，这种关系就破裂了。
And those he calls come from every people.
而这些他所呼召每一个人。
In every language and nation and tribe.
每一个族，每一种语言。
And he draws us into a relationship with himself by making himself known to us.
通过他向我们展示他是什么样的一个上帝，使我们跟他建立一个关系。
And this leads to my final point.
这是你到我的最后一点。
Through Jesus' birth, God is with us.
因为耶稣基督的诞生，神与我们同在。
The prophecy in Isaiah that Matthew quotes says they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us.
马太所引用的以赛亚的预言在二十三章说，以马内利翻出来就是神与我们同在。
This name for Jesus tells us of his nature as God-Man.
所以我们可以看到耶稣基督的神性。
God is with us in the coming of Jesus because God was in Christ.
通过耶稣基督神与我们同在是因为神耶稣基督就是上帝。
As the Gospel of John puts it,
当我们看到约翰福音里面所说的
In the beginning was the Word.
太初有道
And the Word was with God.
道与神同在
And the Word was God.
道就是神
He was with God in the beginning.
他起初就与上帝同在
The Word became flesh,
道成了肉身,
and made His dwelling among us.
坐在我们当中,
we have seen His glory,
我们见过他的荣光,
the glory of the one and only,
就是上帝独生子的荣光,
who came from the Father full of grace and truth.
丰丰满满的有恩典有真理.
No one has ever seen God,
从来没有人见过神,
but God the one and only,
只有上帝的独生子。
Who is at the Father's side,
在上帝的那一边,
has made him known.
把他显明出来。
So we see that Jesus, who is the Word, who is God,
我们看到耶稣基督就是那个道，就是那位上帝。
came and lived among his people.
在他的人当中住了下来。
He came making God known.
他来是是向我们展示这位上帝是一个什么样的上帝。
Now Philip, one of Jesus' disciples,
腓尼，耶稣基督的一个门徒
asked Jesus to show him the Father, that is God.
让耶稣基督显现这个天父给他看。
Jesus said to Philip,
耶稣基督对腓尼说
"A Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father.
所有看到我的就看见了上帝。
How can you say, show us the Father?
你怎么说把天父显给我们看呢？
Don't you believe that I am in the Father and that the Father is in me?
你不相信我天父就在我里面，我就在天父里面吗？
The words I say to you are not just my own.
我给你所说的话不仅仅是我给你所说的。
Rather, it is the Father living in me who is doing His work.
是住在我里面的上帝所说的。
Believe me when I say that I am in the Father and the Father is in me.
相信我当我说我是上帝，上帝是我。
Or at least believe on the evidence of the miracles themselves.
至少你要相信我们所行的神迹。
That's from John 14.
这是在约翰福音第十四章。
Well, as we know Jesus, we know God.
当我们认识耶稣基督的时候，我们就认识了上帝。
For Jesus reveals God.
因为耶稣基督向我们展示了上帝。
The words and work of Jesus are the same as that of God.
耶稣基督的话，耶稣基督的所做的事，就是上帝所说的话，上帝所做的事。
Now it's very important that we understand what is revealed in the name Emmanuel, God with us.
我们能够了解这。耶稣基督这个名字以马内利，神与我们同在的意义是非常的重要。
It shows us the union of the two natures of Christ as fully human and fully God in Jesus.
当我们能够认识到耶稣基督的完全的神性和完全的人性，在他身上完全的统一起来。
He was perfect man and perfect God.
他是完全的人，也是完全的神。
He was like us in all ways, but without sin.
他跟我们各个方面都像，但是他没有犯过罪。
He was not just a phantom spirit with appearance like a man.
他并不是就是说一个灵，只不过是光是一个上帝的一个灵。
He felt pain, hunger, thirst, and tiredness like us.
他跟我们一样，他肉体跟我们一样，他会有饿，有渴，他也会有痛。
He experienced temptations that we experience.
他跟我们一样，也会受到试探。
So he knows what we go through, and he can help us in our time of need.
所以他知道我们所经历的，所以当我们需要帮助的时候，他就会帮助我们。
Yet, as being fully God, he knew all things beforehand.
而他又是一个完全的上帝，因为他预知所有的事情。
He had miraculous powers to heal.
他有能力来医治。
To cast out unclean spirits.
他可以赶鬼。
And to multiply food.
他可以使五饼二鱼变成很多的食物。
To calm violent storms.
他可以使平息风浪。
And to raise the dead.
他可以使死人复活。
And though tempted, he did not sin.
虽然被引诱，但他没有犯罪。
He said about himself that before Abraham was born, I am.
对他对以色列人说，在亚伯拉罕以先就有了我。
And I and the Father are one.
我跟父原为一。
He allowed himself to be called my Lord and my God.
他完全让以色列人称他为我的主，我的神。
And to be worshipped by his disciples.
他接受他的门徒的对他的敬拜。
His ultimate demonstration of divinity was his resurrection from the dead, whereby he conquered sin and death.
他最后的他的神性的完全的彰显是他战胜了死亡，从死中复活。
If we don't have a good grasp of the truth concerning the two natures of Christ, we'll be led into many heresies as false teaching, and thus away from a saving knowledge of Christ.
而如果我们不把耶稣基督完全的神性跟完全的人性联系来，我们会走向很多的异端。
Now, as believers in Christ Jesus,
作为我们在耶稣基督里面的信从他的人，
we also have God with us.
我们与有上帝与我们同在。
He lives in us by the Holy Spirit, whom Jesus sent.
他通过耶稣基督所差派的圣灵住在我们当中与我们同在。
Jesus promised his disciples that after he went away,
耶稣基督向他的门徒许诺说，当他走了以后，
he would send the Holy Spirit.
他会差派圣灵到他们当中。
That same Spirit now lives in the heart of every believer to give him or her faith.
而那个圣灵是给每一个相信的人有这样的信心。
And to convict us of our sin.
来使我们认识到我们自己的罪。
And to strengthen us to live the Christian life.
激励我们走一个 基督徒的道路。
That is a life of holiness.
活一个基督徒的生命就是一个圣洁的生命。
And to give us the power to be His witnesses to the world.
让我们有能力给他做见证。
You too can have God with you.
你们也同样有上帝与你们在一起。
May He be seen in your life of faith and joy during this Christmas season by others.
我们希望我们祷告上帝在这个圣诞节的这个季节给你们平安，给你们信心。
Perhaps you haven't experienced God with you yet.
可能你们当中有一些人还没有经历过上帝与你们同在。
He invites you to come to Him now.
他邀请你就在此时此刻跟他在一起。
And when you do, He will come to live with you.
如果你愿意，他可以住在你的心中。
And he'll give you a new joy.
他会给你新的喜乐。
An inner peace.
里面的平安。
And a love which you never experienced before.
你从未经历过的爱。
He'll be a source of strength and hope.
他是成为你力量跟希望的源泉。
Even when circumstances around you seem totally out of control.
虽然你周围的情况非常的差。
And in your times of deepest sorrow, he'll draw you close and comfort you.
在你的痛苦当中，他会安慰你。
And he'll be with you to resist the devil and overcome temptation.
他会帮助你抵挡魔鬼，抵挡引诱。
And you can experience God with you.
你可以经历上帝与你同在。
And the joy of his salvation from your sins today by inviting him.To be your Lord and Savior.
如果你邀请上帝，邀请耶稣基督成为你的救主，你在今天就可以享受上帝把你从罪当中拯救出来的快乐。
So I invite you to pray, asking Jesus to come into your life by repenting from, that is, turning away from your sins.
我邀请你今天就在这里把耶稣基督邀请到你的心里面，悔改你的罪。
Ask Jesus to forgive you of your sins.
请求耶稣基督来原谅你的罪。
And acknowledge your faith and trust in Jesus alone for your salvation.
承认耶稣基督在你的救赎当中只是你唯一的救主。
Well, may you all have the joy of Christ in your life during this new year.
在新的一年里，我祝大家能够和耶稣基督一起享受。
Rejoicing in the great salvation that He has offered to us.
享受耶稣基督在给我们带来的救恩。
Heavenly Father, we thank you for your promises.
亲爱的天父上帝，我谢谢你给我们的应许。
Of a great salvation from sin that's offered through Jesus.
通过耶稣基督把我们从罪当中拯救出来。
Thank you that Jesus came in the flesh on our behalf.
我们谢谢你耶稣差派耶稣基督住在道成肉身住在我们当中。
That he came to reveal God the Father to us.
他在我们当中向我们展现了我们的上帝。
And that we might have eternal life.
我们可以通过他有永生。
We look to you alone for eternal blessing.
我们仰望你给我们永远的祝福。
In Jesus' name, amen.
祷告耶稣基督的名， amen.